Cops of Reddit, what is the most what the frick happened here moment you've experienced? EMT, but I got to jump in on this one. We responded to a call at a Motel 6 near Washington DC. We get to the room, and there's a skinny guy in tighty white ties at the door screaming incoherently. We go inside the room, and see what he's pointing at. A dude about 300 pounds, but naked, covered in baby oil, that was completely unresponsive on a tarp. We try to get him on the stretcher, but he keeps sliding off. We use the sheets and even curtains to try to get the oil off him, to no avail. We eventually have to call the fire department to help us get him up, and even when we get him on the stretcher, he slides right off. Eventually, we get him strapped in and take him to the hospital. He passed away without ever regaining consciousness. Apparently what happened was this married father of three flew to DC to meet his internet boyfriend. One of their kinks was a dude taking Ambien and letting the other guy face frick him. Doctors suspect that the Ambien caused his epiglottis to relax and baby oil got into his lungs, where it blocked his alveoli. I'm still curious how notifying the family went on that one. Former cop. Was a rookie deputy and got this call that a man got his foot caught in a garden tiller and was bleeding profusely. It was a 20-minute drive running coat, so I had time to plan out my actions. I figured the ambulance would be about 10 minutes behind me, so I was gone a tourniquet above the knee and I assumed he'd be unconscious and or needing CPR. I get there, and it's a big ass farm building with two guys just standing there smoking. I grabbed my medic bag, not a medic, but it had tourniquet, C-collars, gauze etc. I run towards them to ask where the patient was, and they were white as a ghost just smoking, while pointing behind them. I went inside, and behind a big John Deere tractor was a huge PTO driven tiller about 7 feet wide and 3 feet tall. There was my victim, with his back against the tractor tire. His left leg was sucked in the tiller, and wrapped twice around it with the sole of the shoe next to his face and toe pointing towards the left. His femur shot out underneath the tiller, and was beautifully white with no blood. He looked up at me, and said, "Can you help me?" Now keep in mind, I'm 21. Thought this was a garden tiller, and assumed I'd be able to do something, but I was completely out of my element. Two ambulances, the rural fire department extrication team, a welding company to cut the machine apart on scene, a helicopter and a surgeon that came to amputate on scene. Later he was free. Late to the party, but my favorite so far has got to be the tale of the UFO slash aliens. I was a cop on the res for a while, and had my fair share of crazes. One night, I'm out driving around, and I get a call from dispatch. There's a UFO out in one of the farmer's fields. Okay, so I get to the house, and talk with the guy. We know each other, he doesn't seem to be that loony. I turn my spotlight onto said field and sure as shoot, there's something not quite right there. It's metal and shoot. So I go bebopping through the furrows, and hoping my Scardinus isn't showing because this, it's freaky. It was an autumn night with the wind howling, and clouds blowing overhead. I get closer. I have one hand on my holstered gun and the other shining my flashlight. I was rehearsing what I was going to say to our new overlords, and then my brain finally clicks as to what the frick it actually was. A wad of those stupid Mylar balloons. All blown up, and caught on some weeds. Him talking like 20 of those frickers, just chilling and scaring the shoot out of me. I grabbed them, and walked back out to the farmer. He started laughing, and then I did too. I handed them over to him, and got back in my squad, still shaking. The sad part was, he passes away a few years ago, and his family gave me those deflated balloons that he had kept. I have them in my basement now. Eater, holy shit. I work overnights, so I apologize for getting back to everyone so late. I used to work as a cop on the Sisseton-Wahpeton Reservation in South Dakota. Loved every second of it. From playing stoop with the little kids, where we'd sit on the front steps of someone's house and eat snacks, to finding all the different loopholes to get someone help. I miss it, but it's not conducive to family life either. Thanks everyone for all the upvotes, awards, etc. too. I'm taking a slightly different approach in answering this question. A couple of months ago, I got a questionable activity call. It's a catch-all for anything suspicious. The caller stated she believed someone had snuck into her backyard, climbed up onto her second floor deck, and then left an imprint of their deck on her sliding door. I show up to the call about 5 minutes later, and she's mad at me because I didn't schedule an appointment to come over, and her kids saw me. She didn't want her kids to think something bad had happened. After we get past her anger towards me for showing up, she shows me the glass sliding door in question. In all fairness to the caller, there was a sizable smudge and imprint on the glass. However, the imprint looked nothing like any penis I've ever seen. In fact, the imprint looked really similar to the dead bird laying on the deck next to the door. When I pointed out the dead bird and explained my belief that no deck had been placed on her door, the caller became incredibly irate and told me she moved to our city because it was supposed to be very safe, but now she was thinking of moving away because naked people throwing dead birds at her house was more than she could handle. Realizing I would not be able to rationalize with deck bird, I left and wrote my report. Some people don't deserve to call 911 edit. Thanks for the silver edit too. Thanks for the gold. My dad told me the one time he went to a house and a woman pulled something out of her shopping bag and started hitting him with it. He's trying to stop her, but the other officers are all laughing. Finally, he realizes that she's beating him with a dildo. Edit, my dad is loving that. So many people upvoted his story. One time we got a call about a minor wreck in a highway corridor. We get there, I'm handling the accident. 100 yards down there is a car on flats. And another further down from that. Unrelated to the accident. One of the drivers walked back to us and told us a sketchy guy had been stopping at these cars to offer his help in fixing the flats. The theory was that he threw something on the road to flatten the tires so that he could back quote help and get money from the drivers. I'm stuck at the back end of this mess on the radio trying to get another unit to detain the shady guy. All of a sudden I look over and there's a guy in nothing but a hospital gown and in fourth hanging out of his arm just toddling along the shoulder. The nearest hospital was several miles away, so I have no idea how he covered that distance with nobody noticing. So here I'm with 1. A car wreck, 2. A guy possibly flattening tires on purpose, and 3. An escaped hospital patient. All completely unrelated, on a major highway late at night. A friend of mine is a cop in the UK and his story is more WTF as he saw it unfold, but missed how it all started. It was his first week out on patrol, and he was assigned to an experienced partner. They respond to a burglary in progress, and are told that a nearby dog unit was on the scene already. When they arrive at the property, they hear a commotion outside that's clearly between an officer and a suspect, and they open the garden gate to assist the dog unit. What they then witness is a suspect face down on the grass, an officer stamping on the suspect's back whilst holding his arm up near her hip, and shouting stop resisting, and the police dog absolutely going to town on this guy's buttocks with his teeth. The suspect is, unsurprisingly, struggling and resisting, and then ends up kicking the dog. The dog then latches onto the guy's leg, starts ferociously tugging, pulls it off, and then runs towards the new cops on the scene with it. It turns out that was a false leg which no one, except the suspect knew at the time, and my buddy the cop said he just froze whilst trying to figure out how the hell he calls this in, and whether or not he should retrieve the man's leg from the police dog. I've never been a cop, but my dad was for several years and I've heard plenty of stories from him. The one that I think fits this thread best came from early in his career, when he was still pretty much a rookie. He and some of the other cops got called to a house to follow up on an old woman who was suspected to be dead. When they get there, they find out the woman was a big time hoarder with stuff stacked to the ceilings and paths leading to each room barely big enough for one person. While my dad is walking around taking all this in, one of the other officers suddenly puts his hand out and tells my dad to stop right where he was. Dad asked why and the officer said, "You almost stepped on her." My dad looked down to find the old woman dead and buried under her own stuff. I found 3 kids one day running next to a busy highway. The oldest was 5. We finally got them identified and figured out they lived about a mile away. We got there. They were in the care of their adult 20-ish sister, while their parents were on vacation for 2 weeks. The sister decided she'd rather pop Xanax and smoke weed than deal with the kids. So she locked them in their bedroom for about 10 days, occasionally sliding food and water past the door. There were piss stains on the baseboards in the bedroom from where the kids had decided their bathroom should be. Finally, the 5-year-old had enough and figured out how to unlock the bedroom window and make a break for it. That's nowhere near the darkest stuff I've seen. We don't like to talk about it. Edit. Sorry folks, I work nights and just woke up. She went to jail for endangering a child, and as far as I know the case is still pending. The kids were seized by CPS and held by a foster family overnight until the parents could drive home. I used to be a cop. We got a call from a guy who claimed to be the victim of a robbery and was incapacitated in his home and had only just managed to reach his phone and call us. We arrived to a trailer home that was totally empty except for a man in hardcore fetish gear tied to some sort of sixth swing. I mean, there was nothing else in this house except the gym tied to the sixth swing. Nothing, no furniture, not even curtains. Okay dude, what the fuck, six jimp? Well you see, officer, I hired two Asian hookers to spank me while I was in the swing. Nothing illegal there, no sexual acts, just some spanking and they'd leave. Well, the girls arrived, tied me to the swing. Then, two Asian guys showed up, beat the living shit out of me, then pulled up a U-Haul trailer and stole literally everything that I own, before leaving me hanging here with my cell phone, because they said they knew nobody would believe my story anyways, but the cops would probably chase them for a murder. I still don't know if I believe his story, but never found any evidence to suggest that he was lying either. I just didn't find anything at all. In high school I took a criminology course as an elective, and our teacher was a retired officer. When we asked him for his weirdest story, he told us about a repeat offender. The offender was a homeless homosexual gentleman that had a penchant for exhibitionism. He said he got a call out for someone exposing themselves in public, and when he arrived on scene, he found said gentleman with his ankles to sky, naked as the day he was born, with a half-empty bag of avocados and a can of Crisco. After taking him to the station, they found the other half of the avocados strewn about the back of their cruiser. Not a cop, but worked as a park ranger. Came up on a scene with blood everywhere, hoofs sticking up out of a styrofoam cooler, a truck bed full of blood, beer cans everywhere, and an antelope head on the picnic table. Perfect welcome to a campground full of children. Not my story, a friend's. They were responding to a car accident on the freeway. I don't remember the details, but there are several levels of emergency. This was the lowest level. Nobody seriously hurt. Get here but don't rush. They pull up, and the first thing they see is a severed leg laying in the bushes, then a car on its roof. Everyone starts to panic a little bit until they figure out what's going on. Turns out the driver has a prosthetic leg and takes it off when he drives. When the car rolled, it flew out the window. Driver was totally fine, just a few bumps and scrapes, but missing a leg. Too many to choose from, I forget them all. So how about non-fatal ones that are kinda upbeat? Car in a pond. Guy bought the car, hated it, got so angry he literally drove it into a pond and they left. Ticket for littering, cause I jumped in to see if anyone was in the car. Car wrecked in a tree. In a tree, like up in the middle of the branches, I just don't know how. Half missing decomposing dead body from natural death. Turned out the many cats in the house ate half that person. Okay, that one's grocer Idilong had a warrant and got tased by the officer they were with, trying to run from. That was a more of WTF moment hearing it over the radio. Guy going through a divorce and decided to renovate his house at 2 a.m. with a sledgehammer by taking out all the walls and furniture, cause his future ex got awarded the house. Didn't arrest him, was still his house. Just keep the noise down please. I used to be a cop, and one day I was dispatched to a home invasion robbery in progress. Once I arrived I entered the house where several people ranging from senior citizens to young children were zip-tied wrists to ankles. They said in Spanish youth that the homie Arwana was in one of the bedrooms, and that he got off some shots at the suspects. I went to that bedroom and just inside the door was an adult male laying face down. I rolled him over, and he was obviously dead, having been shot 7 times including one in the forehead area. On the other side of the room was the homeowner. He was still alive, and had also been shot 7 times but none were fatal. He was still clucking his empty pistol. He kept saying, "I got those motherfuckers." Apparently what had happened was that the whole family was in the living room when four suspects kicked in the front door. The homie Arwana said he ran to his room to get his pistol to defend himself as they were coming in. He said he had to load it, so while they zip tied the family, he hid in the room. After a few minutes passed, the dead suspect and the others started searching rooms. He said when they got to his, he stood up and they opened fire on each other. The homie Arwana said four people shot at him and he didn't know how many he hit. He said he didn't know he got hit at first, but when he tried to chase the suspects as they ran out, he collapsed. He was hit in both legs, the abdomen and left arm. The guy was such a badass, and he survived the incident. He had actually hit all four suspects. One died and the others showed up at two different hospitals about an hour later. The idiots didn't wear masks, so the family was able to identify TH. They got life in prison. I personally think they were going to kill everyone, and that is why they didn't wear masks. They targeted that specific house because it was harvest season, and they had hundreds of pounds of processed marijuana in different stages of packaging on the property. Some was hanging to dry in a barn. Some was in a big pile broken up in a bedroom, and the rest was packaged in shipping boxes ready to be moved. When this happened, recreational marijuana was not legal yet. The homie Arwana grew it for a medical dispensary, but was way over what he was allowed to grow. Not me, but my dad's a cop. They went in an apartment to get a dead man and had to check his ID card. It said he was a Caucasian expat from the UK, so they were confused as to why the body that they found was that of a black man's. As it turns out, his body had just turned entirely black because he'd been dead for so long. The newbie that they made retrieve the body vomited and fainted, but apparently newbies are made to retrieve the body, so he had to do it in the end. I was a passerby during a public argument between two strangers. I passed by before the police rolled in. What I witnessed: a foreigner trying to fight with a Greek vendor. They started throwing each other around. People step in to separate them, but they won't let each other go. One guy loses his pants and underwear. The other guy is trying to swing at his balls. A young girl rushes in with a chair and breaks it against the head of one of the randoms who tried to separate them. An older grandma throws her shoes at the girl. The guy who got hit by a chair throws the shoes back at the grandma, who gets hit square on the face. The younger girl takes her shoe off and smacks his head again, while the grandma runs over pulling the girl's hair. The guy finally gets a grip on the other guy's penis, while one other guy who is separating them is biting on his head trying to get him to let go. All the while a woman is screaming from the balcony above them, "You thief, stealing balls from children. Thief, I saw you. Give back the balls to the children. Yay. IDKI the man." Edit. Damn, first ever award. I'd like to thank my mom, my dad, the wonderful silver giver, and of course the Greek vendor and but naked guy for making all this possible. I could give you tons of stories from over the years, but for whatever reason, the one that came to mind when I read this post title was, "We deal with this one particular couple M plus F a lot. They are for sure frequent callers, and they call in some craziness every time. Weird medicals, weird allegations of kidnappings, suspicious sightings, all kinds of shoot. Almost none of it has actually happened, and it seems like the calls generally come in the morning hours, after they have long nights of drug use. Anyway, one time we got to their place to deal with their call for that day, and we ended up walking into their bedroom while talking to them. The walls in their bedroom were huge floor-to-ceiling mirrors. There were webcams everywhere, and written in huge lipstick letters on one of the walls, with a live webcam pointed at it, was "Big Pussy Challenge Tuesday 10 PM. That announcement apparently had nothing to do with the call we were on, but there were adult diapers all over the floor, and those were part of the call. Every time we go to their place, we leave going O/O. I'm not a cop, but a friend who has told me about a call from an apartment building where the tenants were complaining about a smell coming from one of the apartments. When they went in, they found the bathtub full of fecal matter. Turns out the occupant had a scat fetish. His parents had money and had to hire a crime scene cleanup crew from 100 miles away to come clean it up. He had never before that day heard of a scat fetish. Come to think of it, I don't think I had either.